ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 21st பாசுரம். ஏற்ற கலங்கள் எதிர்பொங்கி மீதழிப்ப மாற்றாதே பால் சொரியும் வள்ளல் பெரும் பசுக்கள் ஆற்றப்படைத்தான் மகனே அறிவுராய் ஊற்றமுடையாய் பெரியாய் உலகினில் தோற்றமாய் நின்ற சுடரே துயிலழாய் மாற்றாருனக்கு வலி தொலைந்துன் வாசற்கண் ஆற்றாது வந்துன் அடிபணியுமா போலே போற்றியாம் வந்தோம் புகழ்ந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். The fifth scene of Thiruppavai begins from this Pasuram. We saw that Andaal and her friends came to Krishna's palace and successfully woke up Nappinnai, Krishna's consort, in the fourth scene. And now Nappinnai takes charge of them. She takes lead and advises these girls as to how Krishna can be woken up. Nappinnai tells them that you should call out to Krishna in the way he likes to be called. How did Krishna like himself to be called? Krishna always wanted to be known as Vasudeva, the son of Vasudeva, or the son of Nandagopa. He wanted to be known as the son of the soil, meaning he wanted people to know that he had come down as an incarnation, avataram, for their sake as a worldling's son. So here, since these girls are now in Gokulam according to them, they should be calling out to Krishna as Nandagopa's son. And that is what he likes, Nappinnai tells them. So she says, you call out to him as Atrapadaitan Magane, Magane, son, son of the one who has in abundance. What did Nandagopa have in abundance? Atrapadaitan means the one who has in abundance. What did Nandagopa have in abundance? He had cattle in abundance, it seems. And how much cattle did he have? People say, the Purvacharyas, the interpreters of the Thiruppavai say that the amount of cattle present in Gokulam after Krishna's birth was really innumerable. And they go ahead a step further to say that probably one can even count the sins that one is performing, or one can even count the auspicious qualities of the Lord called Kalyanagunas. Both the auspicious qualities of the Lord and our sins are regarded as uncountable by the Vedas. Even if one is able to make an attempt to count these, we cannot count the cattle of Nandagopa chiefs. That amount of bounty Nandagopa had in cattle. So he is called as Atrapadaitan, the one who had in abundance. And the quality of the cattle that he had was even more fantastic. How were these cattle? They were Etra kalangaL edir pongi meedalippa maatrade paal soriyum vallal perum pasukkal. Pasukkal refers to cattle. They were perum pasukkal, the stout cows, and they were vallal perum pasukkal, that is the generous stout cows. And how generous were they? Yetra kalangal edirpongi meedalippa. If we were to keep some vessels to take out milk from them, we would keep only suitable vessels. Yetra kalangal. Suitable vessels means what? If we know that this cow yields a lot of milk, then obviously we'll keep a bigger vessel for collecting the milk. So expecting lot of milk yield, these cowherds would keep big vessels to fill them with milk. But these cows were so generous in giving milk that the moment these vessels were placed under them, they would get filled and they would start overflowing. Yedir pongi meedalippa. And this kind of abundant milk they would give unfailingly. Matra de pal soriyum. Not a single day would a cow refrain from giving milk. Always all the cows were ready to yield generous amount of milk, which would fill the vessels as soon as they were placed under them. So, such generous kind of cattle, in innumerable number, was possessed by Nandagopa. And that Nandagopa's son Krishna. You must call out to Krishna like this. Because Nandagopa likes to be called as son of Krishna likes to be called as son of Nandagopa. And he also likes to be called in association with the cattle who were so generous. The Lord loves people or animals who are generous, because generosity is something which shows abundant mentality. It shows how progressive and positive a person is. And the Lord is always with such progress and optimism. So, he likes to be associated with these generous cows. So, you give him an adjective which is connecting him to both the cows and his father Nandagopa and call him. And so, the girls call out to him, giving all these adjectives that he is associated with Nandagopa, who possesses innumerable number of fantastic quality cattle which yield milk the moment they are trying to be milked at. So, this Krishna should now come out and grace these girls. That is why they have called out to him, as taught by Nappinai. Nappinai tells them another way also to call out to Krishna. She tells them that the Lord is the enthusiastic one. He is so enthusiastic that he is called as Anirvinna. Anirvinna means the one who comes without getting disappointed. The Lord takes so many incarnations, so many avatars. Why is he repeatedly taking avatars? Only because he is expecting that somebody will be saved looking at his avatara or reading about the stories of his avatara. He untiringly takes avatars without getting disappointed, that though he is coming so many times, still so many of us are here. So, that way, he never loses enthusiasm to do something for the devotees. So, he is called as the enthusiastic one. Utramudayai. Nappinai says, call him as Utramudayai. Then he will get reminded that he has come down for y'all. He has taken the incarnation only for you people. So, he will come out. And she then says, but don't think of my concert as somebody who is very easy to attain. He is the greatest one. He is Periyai. Though he is coming down so many times, don't think that he doesn't have value. He is the greatest one. He is known as Parabrahmam, Periyai. Despite being Parabrahmam, he is showing his saulabhya or his compassion and ease of access. So, he is coming down and taking avataras. Ulaginil thotramai nindra sudare tu ilalai. He comes as a sudar, as a precious light which is going to dispel the darkness of ignorance in this world. Though he is the greatest, he has the enthusiasm to come down and take incarnations. That is what she is trying to convey by these three phrases. Utramudayai, periyai, ulaginil, thotramai, nindra sudare. Saying all this, you must wake him up. Tu ilalai, please wake up, O Lord. The girls say, according to how they have been taught by Nappinai. And then they go ahead to say something very, very humble. They say, Matrarunak valitulaindunvasarkan, atradvandun adipaniyuma pole. Potriyam vandom. You know, Krishna, we have come to your door as if we were your enemies who have been defeated. It seems when an enemy is defeated by his enemy, then he loses all his strength and valor and he comes and falls at his feet as if he has no other go. He does not have any other refuge. Thus, we have also come to you as akinchanas. We don't have anything with us. And we have no other refuge than you. Ananya gatihi sharanya. Acharya calls out. Alavandar, the great Acharya, says, you are our only refuge. We do not know of any other refuge. So we have come to you. So also, we girls have come to you, Krishna, like those enemies, Matrar, who have lost their strength, Valitolaindu, and they have come to your door, Unvasar Kan, Atradu Vandu, they have come with no other go, Un Adipaniyuma Pole, and they have surrendered to you. Like that, we have also come, Potriyam Vando, we come and bow down to you, O Krishna, please get up, they say. As these girls talk so humbly and beautifully, Krishna decides that he has to wake up. So, now he is going to wake up in the next pasuram. Let us see how beautifully these girls give him instructions to wake up and come. Krishna has now decided to wake up. But these girls have specification on how he should wake up and come. So, those specifications would be given by these girls in the next pasuram.